When you hit the whammy, you may lose all your money.
Roses are red, violets are blue. Call on the whammy, he'll sock it to you. The whammy is one guy who kiss your money bye-bye. The whammy is a person who will for sure take your purse, son. Roses are red, violets are blue. Land on the whammy, he'll land on you. Don't look the whammy in the eye, or he'll kiss your money bye-bye. We have a strong expression of her feelings from Carrie Ann Helm, age 7, of Osakis, Minnesota. Whammy, whammy, where are you? Stay away, because I hate you. I agree with you, Carrie. We want to thank Sonny Trindle of Phoenix, Arizona, for sending us a group of whammy rhymes that are so good, we'll be featuring them all this week. Sonny, so far, you are the leading contender for the position of Press Your Luck Poet Laureate. And we want to thank you, and here is the first rhyme. You had a bunch of money and lost it to your sorrow. The whammy took it, winked, and said, take 2 aspirin and call me tomorrow. Thanks, honey. While we're fighting the traffic to shop far and near, the whammy smiles and says, you're crazy. I got my goodies from these folks right here. It was the night before Christmas, and all through the game, up jumped a little red man who said, whammy's the name. Skip Reining, Mark Remley, and Tim Evans of Macomb, Illinois want you to remember, the whammy is a greedy little man. He will take all the money he possibly can. Ha. 3 of you took to write this? Here is a sterling admonition from Pam Saperi of Reading, Pennsylvania. If too much money you try to crammy, you might end up with only a whammy. We have a special whammy poem, in effect. It's actually a song sent in by Penny of Santa Rosa, California. She wants to check my dulcet tones. You ready? This is sung to Oh My Darling Clementine. I'd like to have the whole staff, if you will. Oh, my whammy, oh, my whammy, oh, my whammy, whammy, woo. Please don't take my money, honey, 'cause it'll leave me feeling blue. Well, I have a whole new career ahead of me, I think. Here are some words of wisdom from Mrs. Goffin of Cincinnati, Ohio. Peter Tomarken is really no jerk. So how come the whammy gets the money while Peter does the work? Yeah, yeah. Here is a little ditty from Mrs. Brenda Strickland of Hortense, Georgia. And the instructions are to sing this to My Body Lies Over the Ocean. Somebody give me a B flat. Yeah, excellent. Everything but a B flat. Okay. The whammy hides under the button. The whammy hides up on the board. And if you hit one little whammy, he takes all the goodies you've scored. Oh, da, da, yeah. We have some words of wisdom from Scotty Baran of Trenton, New Jersey. Just cool your jets. There's one thing we'd like to know about the whammies you people hire. When does their contract with CBS expire? Like that? Take a hike. We have some words of wisdom, don't we? From Tommy Martin of Murray, Utah. Old Whammy is a slick old guy. He will grab you when he can. But I outsmarted that ugly creep. I got my dough and ran. That really blew you away, didn't it? Take a hike. We have a little poem from Ellen Newell. Just behave yourself. From West Frankfort, Illinois. Here lies the Whammy. He came and went. Big in his time, others' money he spent. He took our riches. Now we are poor. Alas, we will hear his laugh no more. Bye, sucker. Here are some goodies from Taylor Finch, a lovely lady from Santa Barbara, California. Are you ready? Weren't the Academy Awards great, my dear? Ah, yes, but I'll tell you what they need next year. To offer an award for greed and theft. For before you know it, he's come and left. Why, it's your precious earnings that this guy's after, with his greedy grin and his spiteful laughter. So may I have the envelope, please? For I'm sure the winner wholeheartedly agrees that none is more deserving than that money-grabbing whammy. And for all his cruelty, give him a Grammy. Bye for now. And here's one that was sent in for Betty from Georgia McAtee of Iowa City, Iowa. One whammy, two whammy, three whammy, four. And now it doesn't matter, because you ain't playing no more. Here's some words of wisdom from Jeanette Foster of Weatherford, Texas. The whammy's so ugly, he gives me a fright. He makes me so angry, I'm ready to fight. You're to be commended for locking him tight so he can't stray over till the price is right. Thank you, Jeanette. This one's from Debbie Carpenter of Schenectady, New York. I've watched all the game shows morning and night. From Barker to Clark, those hosts are all right. But I love Press Your Luck, and should you ask why, it's Peter Tomarken. He's my kind of guy. Hey, my kind of guy. Tomarken is my... Oh, well, what the heck. This one is from Jan Brown of Rescue, California. Rescue me. Oh, whammy, oh, whammy. How can we have fun if you must continue to steal and run? Our pockets are empty, and yours are so full of it. You say that you're poor, but we know that is bull. See you next time. This one is from Irene Olson of Isfeming, Michigan. I wish to God I could be there. I sit and watch, and it just ain't fair. I'm old and poor and need the cash. I'd fix that whammy with one good smash. Then I'd press and press and press my luck till I came through with lots of bucks. To make my lovely dream complete, I'd get to kiss that guy called Pete. Aw, shucks. I hurt myself. Before then, I have a little piece of news here from Elaine Welch of Green Lane, Pennsylvania. It goes, I'm a whammy, yes I am. E-I-E-I-O, I can take your money, yes I can. E-I-E-I-O, with a whammy here and a whammy there, whammy, whammy everywhere, I'm a whammy, yes I am. E-I-E-I-O, it's obvious that I have no pride. Here is a goodie. It comes to us from Jay Dexter of Medina, Ohio. She writes in, or he, he, of course. What would it be she with Jay? That's ridiculous. Where is this man you call Rod Roddy, whose dulcet tones invade my body? Is Mr. Roddy camera shy, or is he really a talented guy? I am properly representing most of your viewers who want to see who Rod Roddy is, and I'll bet your studio audience can see this announcer whiz. So give old Rod a one-time shot. You have some time left, so why not? Come show Rod on camera three and say to us, Peter, and now by request, here is Rod Roddy.
Yay! Thank you, Peter.
This one is from Cindy Waite Carter, who was a former contestant on Press Your Luck. She's from Lakeside, California. We all hope and pray for the whammy to stray. Well, I held them at bay, and I'm in Hawaii today. I come back home to change my suitcase, for it's off to the ship to purchase Caribbean lace. And I'm still hoping and praying Press Your Luck will be staying. I don't mean to be rude, but it's much better than The Feud. The Feud, is that on a... That's on some kind of UHF station or something? I never... Have you ever seen The Feud? No. Okay, here's another one from Joseph Signorelli of Alhambra, California. This is a little offbeat. A whammy's a bleep for a four-letter word. It starts... Well, you'll have to trust me on this. This is very funny, but I couldn't read this if we were on cable. Real nice, Joe. Woohoo! This is hot! I have a little poem from... This is from Bernice Filiish of Orwigaburg, Pennsylvania. Check this. Peter and Whammy, boy, what a team. One is quite handsome. The other's a scream. On your show, Press Your Luck, which I never miss. One I could strangle, the other I'd kiss. Now, in case you're wondering, a little in doubt, of which is the one that I'm talking about, who is the one that is charming and clever? And who is the one that I'd follow forever? Why, Peter's the one with a voice smooth as honey. But I'll take the whammy. He's the one with the money. Thanks. Thanks a lot, Bernice. Story of my life. I got a joke. I got a joke from Miss Ottilia Nigaglioni. She's 12 years old, and she says, what is the whammy's favorite tourist attraction? Huh? Do you know? Do anybody know? The Vampire State Building. Ellen Rose of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Whammy, whammy, hoop-de-doo, it don't matter about you. I'm not afraid of you anyway. I won't have a Press Your Luck day. So I'll just harass you with this little note. It's Peter Tomarken who gets my vote. A pretty dude and an interesting babbler, an entertaining guy, not a dabbler. Keep on talking, Peter, dressed so dapper. You're my favorite professional rapper. Thank you, Mom. I'll send the $5 right after the show ends. One is from Jean Dunaway of Union, Kentucky. She says, whammy, whammy, oh so mean and filled with all that evil greed. Ha ha, you think you've got big bucks, but now you've just run out of luck. Because Peter gave me your home address and I just called the IRS. Very nice, Jean. Here's one from Scott Royer
of San Diego, California. There once was a pirate named Sammy whose fingers were cold and clammy. He took all the loot and the prizes to boot because his real name is Whammy. Ain't that the truth?
I have a little poem from Poet's Corner here. This one's from Brenda Brinzer of Columbus, Ohio. Press your luck is for all ages, but those whammies send us all into rages. They creep up on you slow and sure. Time they're done, you're certainly poor. My darling 8-month-old loves the show. She loves the noise when those whammies make a no-no. I'd love to see Peter play the game, just to see if he'd feel the same as those poor contestants feel when those whammies give them a raw deal. Let's put Peter in a contestant seat, just to see who gets beat. No way. This one is from Pat Dagunas of Bricktown, New Jersey. It goes something like this. My dear Whammy and Tammy, you make some pair, but you can't forget about me, I want my share. You dance, you sing, you even fly, but you can't escape my eagle eye. The jig's up, you're in a mess. Momentarily yours, signed the IRS. I like that one. Don't you like that one? No, Jill doesn't like that one. Jill used a different name, but don't let that bother anybody. I have a poem from Bill Sharp of Knoxville, Tennessee. Some people think that the whammy is funny, even as he wipes out their dough. And he likes to pretend to be Peter's friend, for he doesn't want him to know that as he rakes in the cash with his wide sweeping slash, his real aim is to steal the show. A crafty little critter, he is certainly no quitter as he tries to lull Peter into a trance. But Peter's no fool. He hangs on to his cool and fights back with a belly dance. Maybe, Rod, is this one to you? I don't know. I got another one, though. From A.T. Gall of Mount Airy, North Carolina. The whammy is mean as he can be. He swipes the prizes from you and me. With all that loot, he should confess how much he owes to the IRS. Yes, the whammy is mean as he can be. Perhaps we'll send him to NBC. Not a bad idea. This one is from Mary Murray of Kanaohe, Hawaii. For your meanness, Whammy, you're not to blame. After all, you're just part of the game. So if you take my money, I'll probably just shrug. But Whammy, stay away from my Flocati rug. Thank you, Mary. This is from Minnie Mulford of Redding, California. Whammy, Whammy, you're so cute when you take away the contestant's loot. But Whammy, Whammy, you didn't play fair when you took the part out of Peter Tomarken's hair. Thanks. Where is it? This one is from Leon Riley of Flint, Texas. The contestants wear grins. They have all earned their spans. Each one is ready and willing, adrenaline flowing, each in his heart knowing that it is he who will make the big killing. But none can discern as each takes his turn just when the whammy will show. Who am I doing? So they all press their luck in search of big bucks. The tension is beginning to grow. The lure of the trips, the thought of cruise ships, of money, a gold diamond pan. Sends common sense routing, leaves contestants shouting, once more, Peter, I'll spend. Yes, I'll spend once more, win riches galore, sucker. I'll really be sitting in clover. Oh, no, each cried, fruition deny. A whammy. Game's over, buddy. See y'all next time now. Take care. Be cool. I have a rather lovely poem from the Taylor family of Cisco, Texas. And they write in, it's the game of the whammies, and the contestants are there. Big bucks and a spin. Is it worth the dare? The whammies are out there without a care, hoping contestants will go home in despair. The contestants will have a chance to spin, press their luck or pass, which one will win. Big bucks, a trip, and a new car, too. Whammy doesn't care. He'll take them all from you. Yes, there's lots of excitement on the Press Your Luck show, but Peter, it isn't fair to you, you know. Anyone can be whammied. Now, isn't that true? Anyone, Peter. Yes, anyone but you. Hey, you're right. And they sent me a little whammy. The Taylor family made a little whammy. Does this look like, this looks like a game show host, would it be, no, you think it looks, no, he doesn't look, no, he doesn't wear that color shirt, that Pat, no, it's not, no way, anyway. Chris Leggio, Bill Harmon, and Joe Kennedy, who were prior contestants on Press Your Luck, who have still trying to eat their way through a lifetime supply of rice-a-roni. They did send us a little poem. I'll read it to you. It's, now, all the poems you ever hear are about that pesky whammy. He dances and jives in front of the screen, so you'll go home and cry to your mammy. But the creature featured in this little tale is the voice with the stellar body. No, it's not the host or the producer you see. It's the remarkable Rappin' Rod Roddy. Now Rappin' Rod is a stellar old boy who entertains the audience right. His voice is dynamic with pronunciation, you see, but his clothes will give you a fright. He gives away prizes and gifts to all, while both the contestants and audience keep a hearken. The only thing Rappin' Rod Roddy lacks is the sex appeal of Peter Tomarken. I have a little goodie here. This one is from Marie Gauthier of Victoria, British Columbia. She writes in, eyes are good for viewing things, and hands are good for doing things. Fingernails are good for picking things, and a tongue is good for licking things. A nose is good for smelling things, and a mouth is good for telling things. Ears are good for hearing things, and feet are good for hearing things. I'm not sure what eyebrows do, as the same goes for toenails too, but whammies, well, whammies, what can I say? Whammies are just good for taking things away. Let's do this one again. I want to do this one, and we'll do it even faster. Harry, ready? Okay. Keep up if you can. Eyes are good for viewing things, and hands are good for doing things. Fingers are good for picking things, and tongue is good for licking things. And nose is good for smelling things, and mouth is good for telling things. Ears are good for hearing things, and feet are good for hearing things. I'm not sure what eyebrows do, and the same goes for toenails. But whammies, well, whammies, what can I say? Whammies? Just good for taking things away. Thanks. I have a letter, which is a poem sent in by Christy Smith of Yorba Linda, California. Peter Tomarken, an outstanding host. Peter Tomarken, an outstanding host. Maybe... I didn't read that. What does that say, that first line, Tessie? Read that. Nice and clear, does it say?
It says, Peter Tomarken, an outstanding host.
Yeah, you sure? I mean, I want to make sure that. Anisha, what does that say?
Oh, Peter Tomarken is an outstanding host.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. Dave, what do you think it says right there?
It says, Peter Tomarken, an outstanding host.
Don't play around, Dave. Don't play. Send in by Mrs. Tomarken, my mother. That's nice. But it does say, in case you didn't hear, Peter Tomarken, an outstanding host. Oh, what do they know? Rod Roddy announces far better than most. Contestants scream and yell as they play, hoping to scare all the whammies away. But beware of the whammy. They come as they please and take away all your money with obvious ease. Play to win, but know it's no joke. When whammies come and you start to choke, wish them away, have faith, my friend. Cause with four of the whammies, you're at a dead end. Thank you, Christy. That's very nice. From Ruth Fisher of Peoria, Illinois. Big bucks puts you in a tizzy until those darn whammies get busy. Lady Luck, you can't beat her, but Peter, please tell me, does that revolving stage make you dizzy? Doesn't take the stage to make me dizzy. Thank you very much. Until next time, this is Peter Tomarken. Thanks for trusting your luck. Bye-bye.